Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta and this is our next lecture on class 9 chapter 2 exercise 2.3. So before to start the video, I request to everyone please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to the end. So according to the spreading of the coronavirus throughout the world, so please stay at your home and be safe. We will study at home by using online learning classes. So don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes and do it share with your friends and please press the button of likes. Now we have to start our first topic. What's the first topic is this? Divide P of x. P of x means we have to divide a polynomial by g of x. G of x is what? This is your another polynomial. It means we have to divide a polynomial with another polynomial. We already know how to divide a number. So same concept we have to do apply on the algebraic polynomials. Please make a look first how we can divide a number as you already know. If our number is 7 and I want to divide it with 2, I am going to divide it by 2. 2 3s are 6. So we get 1. So this can be written as 7 is your number which is equal to, if we do multiply this, 2 into 3 plus 1. 2 into 3 6 plus 1 which is equal to 7. So this is a representation how we can divide some number. And you know what is it is 7. What is 7 is dividends. So this one is dividend. Now what is 2? 2 is your divisor. So 2 is divisor. And what is 3 is? 3 is quotient. And now what's the 1 is? 1 is your remainder. So according to this, we can write a number in terms of divisor, quotient and remainder. What's the logic behind it? Dividend is equal to product of divisor and quotient plus remainder. This is the basic representation how we can write whenever we have to divide a number with another number. This is a representation. Now I am going to take another example. Please make a look here. If I am divide 7 divided by 2, but today I am changing the number. Here the number is 7, but now I am going to take a number 8. So I am going to take a number 8. The only difference is here what? The number 7 and in this number is 8. And we know 2 fours are 8. It means if we write this, how I can write this? 8 is your dividend which is equal to divisor is what? 2 is your divisor multiply quotient. Quotient is what? 4 plus remainder. And what is your remainder is? 0. In this case what we will get? We get remainder is 0. So from this point we get another point things regarding a division. It means if we divide a number and get a remainder is 0, it's a meaning that is a factor of that number. Again I repeat, whenever you divide a number with another number and you get a remainder is equal to 0, so you can show that divisor is a factor of the dividend. What it is here? Here 2 is what? 2 is your factor. 2 is a factor of what is dividend is here? 8. So please keep it in mind, because we are going to use this concept to find out the remainder. And if we know this one is a factor of the dividend, then the remainder is zero. Please make a note. We have to use this concept. And also dividend divisor quotient plus remainder, how we can represent it in terms of our polynomial. So please make a note. Dividend is represented by a polynomial p, p of x. So it is represented by p of x. And divisor is represented by g polynomial, g of x. So it is g of x multiplied. Quotient is represented by a symbol or a letter q. So it is represented by q plus. And remainder is represented by a letter r, small letter r of x. So we get a relation. What's the relation is? Please make a note here. P of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. This is a relation, and this relation is basically called Euclid division. This is basically called Euclid division, or you can say that Euclid division algorithm. So you have to keep it in mind, what's the relation is. This is dividend, this is divider, divisor, this is quotient plus remainder. You have to learn this relation, because we have to use this relation in this exercise. So please make a note whole things and keep it in your minds, because these questions are very simple if you do learn these steps. Please make a note first. Now what we have to do? We have to do division. Is very very simple. Now please look a statement. What it state? It state divide p of x, and we know what sa px is. Px is your dividend polynomial, and by a g of x, and g of x is what? G of x is your divisor polynomial. So we know how we can write a division. Firstly, we have to write a symbol of division, and inside this we have to write the dividend. And what is dividend in this case? P of x. And we know the values of px of is what? X plus 3x square minus 1. Please make a note first. Firstly, you have to arrange the terms according to descending order. Step 1. What's the step 1 is? Please make a note. Step 1. Arrange the terms in descending order. Now what we have to do? We have to do first arrange the terms in descending order, means we have to write first higher terms. High terms means the terms which has highest power of the variable, then smaller, and in this manner we have to write the each polynomial, either p of x or g of x. So what is p of x is what? X plus 3x square minus 1. So what we get? P of x is equal to highest power of, in this expression is 3x square. So that's why we have to write 3x square. Then here the power of x is 2. Then we have to decrease 1. It means we get x, then 1. It means we have to arrange these terms in descending order, because here the power is 2, here the power is 1, but in this case power is 0. So we have to write all the polynomial in descending order. And again make a note, there should be no missing term. I am again repeat a concept. There is no term missing. Suppose if this x is not specified in the polynomial, then we have to write in that place of x is 0 into x. We have to do some quotient in next step. So please do our first step. What we have to do? We already did. We arrange the terms in the descending order. So please do. Our polynomial is 3x square plus x plus 1. Now what we have to do? In this place we have to write the divisor, and divisor is what? G of x. And we know what is g of x is 1 plus x. So we have to write the order. Order is what? G of x is, first we have to write x, then we have to write 1. We have to keep, maintain the order of the terms of the polynomial, either p of x or g of x. So now we have, I am writing here x plus 1. Now the step is what? Our first step is we already did. Now our second step, we have to take the first term of the dividend polynomial is what? 3x square, and divide it by the first term of the divisor polynomial. And here the divisor polynomial first term is x. So I am taking x. Again I repeat the concept. Firstly you have to write the first term of the dividend polynomial. Dividend polynomial is what? This is, so first term is 3x square. I am writing here 3x square. And you have to write the first term of the divisor polynomial, and that first term is x. So now divide it. We already know, because in this the power of x is 1 and the power of x is here 2. So 2 is cancelled out with 1. What we will get? We get only 3x. So we get 3x because 1 power is cancelled out. You can also write as 3x square means 3 multiply x multiply x, and divide is x. So x is cancelled out with x. What we will get? We get 3x. So I hope you are understanding this concept, because it's very very easy. We already did in an exercise in your class 8. We have did so many questions in the class 8, such types of divisions. Now what we will get? We get 3x. Now put it here, 3x. Now third step is what? Now you have to do multiply this with divisor. You have to do multiply this number by the divisor and write here. Now 3x multiply x, what we will get? We get 3x square, because 3x into x we get x square, so we get 3x square. Now we have to do multiply plus. Please make a note first. I hope you understand this concept. It's very easy. Now we have to do 3x into 1. What we will get? 3x into 1 which is 3x. Our next step is, please make a note, we have to write the terms below the same power of variable, because in this the variable power is 2. So we have to write the term same, below the same power of the variables. Now what we have to do? Our next step, we have to change the sign of the denominator. This term is your denominator, and we have to change the sign. In this there is no sign is specified, so we have to take sign is positive. If this sign is positive, then we have to change the sign, so we make it negative. Here sign is positive, so we have to make it negative. Please make a note, if no sign is specified, it means the sign is positive. And you have to change the sign of all the terms of the below this term. So now you have to solve this. Please make a note, this is positive 3x square and this is negative 3x square. Both the terms are same, but sign is opposite. And we know 2, if we know 2 minus 2, this is positive 2, this is negative 2. They are cancel out each other, so we get 0, and there is no need to write 0. So in this 3x square is cancel out. Now solve this. This is plus x. Plus x means 1x. This is your 1x. 1x. And this is your minus 3x. You have not considered these sign. You have to take the sign below. So this is 1x. And this is negative 3x. What's the result? Result is minus 2x. Because 3x minus x is 2x. And the sign is bigger term, is negative. So we get minus 2x. Now we all did subtraction. Now the remaining terms, if any possible, you have to write as it is in the this area. So here we get as it is term plus 1. Now we have to do the same step. What's the same step is? Again we have to divide. Now take it first term. Here the first term is minus 2x. And we have to take first term is here x. Now solve this. X is cancelled out with x. What we will get? We get minus 2. It means we have to write here minus 2. And the same step, we have to multiply this with our divisor. Now to multiply, minus 2 into x, we get minus 2x. Now to minus 2 into plus 1, we get minus 2. Now our next step is, we have to change the sign. Here the sign is negative, so we have to make it positive. Here the sign is negative, we have to make it positive. Now solve this. This is negative 2x and this is plus 2x. It means the terms are same but signs are opposite. So they will cancel out. So these are cancelled out. Now this is plus 1 and this is plus 2. Because this again I am repeating, you have not taken the sign of middle signs. You have to take the sign upper and below, not the sign of middle terms. So you have to ignore these signs. So what's the result? This is plus 1 and this is plus 2. Plus 1 and plus 2 is plus 3. It means we get 3. And please make a note, in this highest power of x is 1. In this highest power of x is 1. But in this case there is no x. It means the highest power of x is 0. If you get here highest power and here lowest power, that means your answer is complete. So we did our question. This is very very simple. Now how we can write it as? What's the result is? P of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. If I am saying, what is our q of x? Question is what? Question is this. So we get 3x minus 2. This is our quotient. And what is remainder? Remainder is what? Plus 3. So this one is our answer. Please make a note and write all the steps according to your level of understanding. You keep writes according to your way. Please make a note. Now we have to take our next question. So please try to do it yourself, because it's very very easy. You have to know the each step of the question, then the such type of question becomes very very easy. Now we have to do our next question. Divide the polynomial. This is polynomial by x minus 1. It means we have to divide this polynomial by this polynomial, and this becomes a dividend. And we know dividend is represented by p of x. And what is, we have to divide it by, so this becomes your divisor. So this is divisor, and we know divisor polynomial is represented by g of x. So we get p of x is this and g of x is this. Now our first step is what? We have to arrange the polynomial in descending order. Please make a note here. Here the power of x 4, 3, 1 and 0. It means power is in descending order, but keep a note. I am writing here. What is our P of x is what? 3x raised to the power 4 minus 4x raised to the power 3 minus 3x minus 1. In this power are arranged in descending order. Because here the power is 4, then 3, then 1, 0. It means power are descending. But keep a note. What we have to note? The one term is missing. What's the term is? Because 4, 3, then 2. Where is 2? It means the term x raised to the power 2 is missing. So firstly we have to write our polynomial, that polynomial in which there is no missing terms. So we have to write the missing term as a 0. So please make a note here. So we have to write it 3x raised to the power 4 minus 4x raised to the power 3. And we have to specify x raised to the power 2, but the coefficient is 0. So we can write 0x raised to the power 2 because this term is missing and missing term is represented by a coefficient 0. Our next term is minus 3x and next term is minus 1. Now this becomes our complete polynomial. Now what we have to do? Our g of x is what? X minus 1. In this the highest power of x is 1 and in this 0. It means this is already arranged and there is no missing terms. It means our expression p of x and g of x are correct. Now we have to do our second step. Second step is what? We have to divide. So how we can write as? Firstly we have to write in this portion our dividend. What is dividend is p of x. Please make a right. 3x raised to the power 4 minus 4x raised to the power 3 plus 0x raised to the power 2 minus 3x minus 1. And here we have to write g of x, divisor polynomial. G of x is what? X minus 1. Now our next step is what? We have to take the first term of the dividend polynomial. What's that first term is here? 3x raised to the power 4. 3x raised to the power 4 divided by first term of the divisor polynomial. And first term is here x. Now 1x is cancelled out with 4. So what we will get? We get 3x cube. Because 1 power is cancelled out, we get only x cube. So this term becomes 3x cube. So right here 3x cube. Next step is what? We have to do multiply it with this divisor polynomial. Now do multiply 3x cube into x. Now 3 is your number. Here the number is 1 because no number is specified. X means 1 into x. So 3 into 1, 3, and x cube into x, x raised to the power 4. So we get x raised to the power 4. Now do multiply 3x raised to the power 3 multiply by minus 1. We get minus 3x raised to the power 3. Now what we have to do? We have to change the sign. Here the sign is positive because we know the term has no sign. It means the term has positive sign by default. So we have to take the sign negative. Here the sign is negative. So we have to make it positive. Now solve this. This is positive and this is negative. So terms are same. Sign is opposite. So they are cancelled out. So these terms are cancelled out. Now this is minus 4x raised to the power 3. This is plus 3x raised to the power 3. Please make a note. You have to take the number, not you have to take the variables. Here the number is minus 4 and here the number is plus 3. Minus 4 plus 3 is what? Minus 4 plus 3 is what? Minus 1. It means we have to write minus 1 into variables is as it is. So we have to write minus 1x cube. Now the remaining terms we have to write as it is. So what we have to write? 0x square -3x -1. Now we have to do the same step. Now we have to take our first term is what? -1x square and divide by first term, which is x. So if we divide, 1x is cancelled out. So what we will get? We get minus x. So we have to write here minus x. Now the same step we have to do, multiply minus x into x, we get minus x. Sorry, what we have to do? Our first term is what? Minus 1x cube. This is minus 1x cube. First term is this. And we have to divide by it. What's the power is? 2. So we get minus x raised to the power 2. Because here the first term is minus 1x raised to the power 3. So in this what we have to do? Minus x square. Now do the same step. We have to do multiply. Minus x square with x, we get minus x cube, because we can also write it as 1, because if we multiply by 1 we get the same number. So if you write 1 or not, it's not necessary to write 1 every time. You can write only x cube also. So now our minus x square is multiplied with negative 1. Negative negative becomes positive, so it becomes x square. Now we have to do the same step. We have to change the sign. This sign is negative. We have to take it, make by positive sign. Now this is positive. We have to take sign negative. Now we have to solve. This is negative sign and this is positive sign. It means they are cancelled out. So these terms are cancelled out. Now what we will get? We get here 0x square. Here is what? Here is no number is specified. It means 1. It means this is 1x. This is 0. This is 1. 0 and 1 is 1. The sign is bigger term is negative. 1 is negative minus 1 and this is positive. And we know minus 1 plus 0 is what? Minus 1. So we get minus 1 and the variable terms is as it is. So variable term is what here? X square. So we have to write my x square as it is. Now the remaining terms we have to write as it is. So remaining terms is here negative 3x and negative 1. Now our next step is same. We have to take our first term. What's the first term is here? Our first term is negative 1x square and here the first term is x. So it means we have to cut x raised to the power 1. We get negative x. So write here negative x. Now do same. Minus x into x, we get minus x square. Now minus x into minus 1, we get plus x. Now next step is we have to change the sign. Now to change the sign, this is negative, we make it positive. This is positive, we have to make it negative. Now write, this is negative, this is positive, same terms. So these are cancelled out. Now solve this. This is negative, this is negative, 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 positive, and sign is negative. This is minus 3 and this is minus 1. So we get, because here is no sign, so we can write 1x. This is minus 3 and this is minus 1. We get minus 4. X variable is as it is, because we doesn't change the variable. We have to take, add or subtract only the number, not the variables. Now what's the remaining term is? Negative 1, we have to write it as it is, minus 1 as it is. Now what we have to do? We have to take our first term. Now our first term is what? I am writing here what we will get? Minus 4x minus 1. This is here. I am writing here. Now our first step is what? Minus 4x, and we have to divide by first term is x. So x is cancelled out. What we will get? We get minus 4. So we have to write here minus 4. Now loop multiply. Minus 4 into x, we get minus 4x. Now minus 4 into minus 1, we get plus 4. Now next step is again change the sign. This is negative, we have to make it positive. This is positive, we have to make it negative. Now look at, this is negative term and this is positive, so they are again cancel out. This is negative, this is negative, 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 positive, sign remains negative. So sign is negative, and negative 4, negative 1, we get negative 5. So what's our answer is negative 5 as a reminder. And what is our this? This is what? This is our quotient, and this is our what? Remainder. So please make a note. I was write this step here, but you have to do in fair your notebook as it is, because here my space is becomes small. That's why I'm write this here. Please make a note. Now we are going to take our next question. Please make a look. Find the remainder obtained on dividing p of x by this polynomial. It means this is our dividend polynomial and this one is our divisor polynomial. So this question is very simple. So please make a note what we are going. We have to take this question solve by two methods. One is called as that we already done. This is method. We already take some questions. This method is called long divisor method. So firstly we take questions are based on long divisor method, but we have another method which is called remainder theorem method. We have to take this question by two method. So first I am going to take our first method. Method first, using long division so I am going to take it with long division because this is very simple. How we can do? As you know, firstly we have to write a symbol. In this case, we have to write the dividend polynomial. So please make a look here. What is dividend is? P of x is x cube plus 1. Step is what? We have to arrange in descending order. X cube means the highest power of 3. In this case, the highest power of x is 0. So this is already arranged. But keep a note. Kya? That is a terms that is x raised to the power 2 is missing, x raised to the power 1 term is missing. So we have to write generalized form. In the missing terms we have to use its coefficient is 0. So please make a write. So what is our p of x is this? We have to write in this firstly x cube. Now x square is missing, then we have to write it 0 x square. So I am representing it by 0x square. Now x is also missing, so I have to use 0 into x. Now this is x, 3 power, 2 power, 1 power, and what is 0 power is 1. It means we write all the terms. Make a note, there should be no missing terms. Now we have to write the divisor polynomial. Divisor polynomial is also arranged because in the x raised to the power is 1 and in this x raised to the power is 0. So it is arranged in descending order. So there is no need to change the order. We have to write it as it is. Now what we have to do, our first step is we have to take first term. Here first term is x2 divided by first term, which is x. If we divide it, we get x raised to the power 2, because 3 minus 1, 2. So we have to write here x2. Now do multiply x square into x, which is equal to x cube. Now do multiply x square into 1, we get 1x square. Now what we have to do? We have to do our next step, change the sign. Here the sign is positive, so we have to make it negative. Here the sign is also positive, we have to make it negative. Now this term is positive and this term is negative, so these terms are cancelled out. Now look at, this is 0, this is 1, this is negative 1 and this is plus 0. So we know negative 1 plus 0 is negative 1. So we get negative 1x square. Now the remaining terms we have to write as it is, 0 into x plus 1. Now our first term is here, minus 1x square. So I am writing here minus 1x square. And divide by first term is x. If we divide by this, what we will get? Minus 1x. And you can, minus 1x can be written as only x. So you can also represent it by x, or you can also write minus 1x. Both can be same. Now do multiply minus x into x. We get minus x square, or you can write minus 1x square. Now multiply minus x into 1, we get minus x. Now step is next, change the sign. Here the sign is negative, so I am going to make it positive. Here the sign is also negative, so I am going to make it positive. So this is negative, this is positive. Terms are same, so these are again cancel out. What we will get? Here the sign is, here the number is not specified, it means the number is 1. It means the number is 1. This is negative, this is positive 1, and this is positive 0. 1 plus 0 is what? 1. So we get 1. And we have to write x as it is. You can write 1 into x, or you can write x as it is. Now the remaining term is what? 1. So our next step is what? We have to take again first term. In this first term is what? 1x. So I am writing 1 into x. Divide by first term is x. So if we divide by cut, we get 1. It means we have to do multiply it with 1. Now do multiply 1 into x. We get 1x. Now 1 into 1, we get 1. Now change the sign. This is negative, because this is, here is positive. This is positive, we have to make it negative. Now please make a look. These are terms same. Signs are opposite. So these are cancelled. Again, this is positive 1 and this is negative 1. Terms are same. So these are also cancelled. So we get a remainder 0. So what's the remainder is 0. And this is our what? This is our q of x. And what is our r of x is 0. So please make a note. So please make a note. Here we get remainder is 0. Now we have to do, use our second method to find out the remainder, which is called remainder theorem. Firstly, you have to keep it in your minds and make a note. So our next method is remainder theorem. What it states? Firstly, I describe the what's the difference between these two methods. First method is your long division method. In this method, where we use, or where we have to apply, and what type of situation you have to do this method. Whenever you find out the qx and rx, you have to use this method. Please make a note here. Whenever the question wants to find the question as well as remainder. You have to find two terms, question as well as remainder. Then you have to use this method, long division method. And if such a question asks you to find only the remainder, then there is no need to apply such a long method. You can use another method which is called remainder theorem method. What's the remainder theorem? In this, whenever you only find the remainder, you have to do apply this concept. It's very easy and calculates this solution very quickly within 2-3 seconds. How is it? Please make a note. This is your remainder theorem. Please make it not in your fair notebook also. Let P of x is a polynomial of greater than degree 1. It means whenever you have a polynomial whose degree is greater than 1. Please look at here. This is a polynomial. And the what's the degree? Degree is what? The highest power of the variable. In this, highest power of the variable is 3. So the degree of the polynomial is 3, which is greater than 1. Now, if you divide this polynomial by any polynomial which is in the form of x minus a, a is what? A is your any real number. If you compare it with this, because this is your polynomial which is greater than 1 degree, and x minus a is what? We have to divide it by this. It means this is a divisor, and here the divisor is x plus 1. If we compare it, x plus 1, if we compare it, how we can write it? There is two methods. Whatever you apply, it's your choice. First method is used. Here x is x, but here the sign must be negative, but the sign is here positive. So you can make it negative. How is it make it negative? You can write it as x minus minus 1. Because negative negative becomes positive and we get plus 1. So if we compare this x x negative negative, so what's the values of a is what? A's value is minus 1. So we get a is minus 1. Please make a note here. If you divide by this polynomial, we have to compare. In this we have to divide by x plus 1. So I am going to take comparison. In this x, we have x, but the sign again negative, but the sign is here positive. So we can write positive means negative into negative becomes positive. So I am right here negative negative. So negative negative becomes positive. Now if we compare x x negative negative, now what's the value of a is what? Negative 1. It means we get a value is minus 1. And what's the remainder? Then the remainder is what? Remainder is our this P of A. This is our answer. What's the value of A is what? A is here negative 1, and we already take such question in exercise 2.1. What we have to do? We have to change the value. Here the function is x. We have to put x is equal to negative 1. So we get the desired expression. Now put our polynomial is, we have to put x is equal to negative 1. If we put here negative 1 cube plus 1. Negative 1 cube means if we multiply negative 1, negative 1, negative 1, it becomes negative 1. So we get negative 1 and this is positive 1 and we get answer is 0. And you already know what's the answer of this is 0. So we have verified. So please make a note this. If you do have some confusion about the values of A, then the simplest method is what? You have to put it equal to 0. If I am putting x plus 1 is equal to 0, you have to put divisor is equal to 0 and solve and find the values of x. If we solve this x, if we take 1 on the right hand side, it becomes negative 1. It means we have to put x is equal to minus 1 in the polynomial. And what we done here, we just put the values of x is minus 1, because in this x we have to put minus 1, this is plus 1 as it is, and we have to solve. So I think you hope, I hope you understand this concept. I am going to take some more examples how that your concept will be clear. So please make it in your fair notebook also, because this is the shortest you can find out remainder as soon within 2 or 3 seconds by using this method. This is becomes very lengthy whenever you find only the remainder. So please make a note. I hope you understand this concept, because this question is very very easy. Now look at the question. Find the remainder, it means we have to find only the remainder. So there is no need to apply the long division method. You have to do apply only the remainder theorem. So you can do it within 2 or 3 seconds. So please do it yourselves. I am also doing here. What is our polynomial is this. P of x is what? X raised to the power 4 plus x raised to the power 3 minus 2x raised to the power 2 plus x plus 1. First step is what? We have to put divisor is equal to 0. What's the divisor is here? X minus 1. Divisor is what here? X minus 1. We have to put equal to 0 and find out the values of x. If we take this negative 1 on the right hand side, it becomes positive ones. So we have to find the polynomial at x is equal to 1. So put x is equal to 1. What's our polynomial is this? We have to put x is equal to 1. Now solve this. X 1 raised to the power 4 plus x 1 raised to the power 3 minus 2 1 raised to the power 2 plus 1 plus 1. Now solve it. 1 raised to the power 4, because 1 into 1 into 1, which is 1. Same here, 1 minus 2, 1 raised to the power is here, again 1. So we get 1 plus 1. Now 1 plus 1, 2 into 1, 2 minus 2 plus 1 plus 1. Now what's the values? 1, 2, 3, 4, which is 4 minus 2. Answer is 2. So final answer is your 2. So it's very very simple. So you have to do in this manner if the question asks you to find the remainder. And if the question asks you to find the remainder by using long division method, then the step you have to follow the long division method. Otherwise, you can do by using remainder theorem. I hope you concept this concept will be clear to you. So please make a note first. So if you really like my video, so don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes and share it with your friends. Don't forget to share it and press the button of like. Then I will prepare a next video for the exercise 2.3. Before this, you have to do all the examples that I explained in this lecture. You have to note it in your fair notebooks. Please make a note.